A very good morning, friends. Today's topic of discussion is calcium. This is an important LAQ for university exam, and you may get a case on tetany from this topic. We'll discuss this topic under the heading of introduction, then sources, recommended daily allowance, absorption, then biochemical functions, regulation of calcium in our body, and clinical significance, in which we will see about hypo and hypercalcemia. Coming to the introduction of calcium, total body calcium is 1 to 1.5 kg. Of this total body content, 99% of calcium it is found in bones and teeth. And remaining 1% of calcium it is in extracellular fluid, which is important for number of functions in our body. This calcium, it is predominantly present in milk and milk products. So sources, the important sources include milk and milk products. It is also present in meat, egg, fish, and vegetables. Cereals and pulses. So these are the important sources of calcium. In recommended daily allowance, for adult, RDA of calcium is 800 milligram. For the children, it is 1.5 gram. In pregnancy, lactation, and in menopause, the requirement of calcium increases and it is up to 1.5 gram. So this is a RDA of calcium. Now coming to the biochemical functions, it is important constituent of bone and teeth, or important component of bone and teeth. It is mnemonic for remembering the calcium functions. It is BCCI, means have heart. This is the mnemonic to remember the functions of calcium. B for bone and teeth formation. Calcium along with phosphate, it is required for the formation of hydroxyapatite, it helps in the mineralization of bone, then second function, important in muscle contraction. Contraction of muscle, it increases the action of actin and myosin. It is required for, or it facilitates excitation contraction coupling. So it is important in muscle contraction. Then third important function of calcium is it is coagulation factor 4. Calcium is a factor 4 in the coagulation cascade. So this calcium is positively charged. It get binds with the negatively charged prothrombin. Because of gamma carboxylation or because of gamma carboxyglutamic acid, which is present in factor 2, 7, 9 and 10, which is activated by vitamin K. So negatively charged prothrombin binds with the positively charged calcium and helps in the conversion of prothrombin to thrombin. And hence it helps in coagulation. Then it is responsible for integrity of cell membrane. Integrity of cell membrane. It is also responsible for transport of different ions across the membrane. So it is responsible for permeability across the membrane. Permeability of different ions across the membrane. Then calcium is a second messenger in the hormone action. It involves, calcium is involved in the pathway which is by the IP3-DAG, inositol triphosphate and diacylglycerol pathway. Example is glucagon. Calcium is second messenger for glucagon and it is also responsible for release of certain hormones. It is also responsible for release of hormones. This is from this H. Then E. Calcium, it is required for activation of certain enzymes. Activation of enzymes. It includes calcium magnesium ATPase, then adenylate cyclase, then pyruvate kinase, pyruvate dehydrogenase, pyruvate carboxylase, also glycogen synthase, these are the different enzymes which are activated, which gets activated by calcium or calcium calmodulin complex. Then it is important in nerve impulse transmission. It is involved in the secretory processes. Secretory processes means endocytosis, exocytosis, etc. Then it is responsible for release of certain hormones. Hormones are insulin, vasopressin, parathyroid hormone, etc. Then it has action on the heart. Calcium prolongs the systole. So these are the different functions of calcium in our body. Bone and teeth formation, muscle contraction, coagulation factor 4, integrity and permeability of the membrane, second messenger, activation of enzymes, nerve impulse transmission, secretory processes, that is endocytosis, exocytosis, then release of certain hormones and prolongs the systole. So these are the important functions of calcium in our body. Now coming to the regulation of calcium level in our body. It is mainly by three hormones, that is parathyroid hormone, vitamin D and calcitonin. So calcium homeostasis, it is maintained with the help of three hormones. Normal calcium level, serum calcium level is 9 to 11 milligram per dl. Of this blood calcium, 50% of the calcium, it is free or it is in ionized form. 40% it is bound to the protein bound, and remaining 10% it is in association with bicarbonate, phosphate, etc. So 50% calcium is ionized calcium. Now calcium homeostasis is maintained with the help of three hormones. First one is the vitamin D. Vitamin D increases the absorption of calcium. Increases absorption of calcium from intestine. This is through the calbindin protein. Vitamin D increases the synthesis of calbindin at the genetic level, and calbindin increases the absorption of calcium from the intestine. This is the first. Second, vitamin D is important for bone mineralization. And third, on the renal system, it increases the reabsorption of calcium along with the phosphorus. So vitamin D increases the absorption of calcium, responsible for bone mineralization, and increases the reabsorption of calcium and phosphorus from the renal tubules. Then parathyroid hormone, it is responsible for demineralization and decalcification. So it is responsible for increase in serum calcium level. Second, it increases the vitamin D. So indirectly it increases the absorption, intestinal absorption of calcium, and it increases the reabsorption of calcium from the intestine. So these two hormones, vitamin D and parathyroid hormone, they are responsible for increase in serum calcium level. While calcitonin, it is responsible for decrease in serum calcium level. It acts oppositely to that of the parathyroid hormone. It is important in mineralization of bones. Then it decreases the reabsorption of calcium and decreases the intestinal absorption of calcium. So in this way, vitamin D, parathyroid hormone and calcitonin regulates the calcium level in blood. Now coming to the absorption of calcium, it is against the concentration gradient with the utilization of energy from the first and second part of duodenum. Now coming to the clinical significance, the serum calcium, it is estimated by two methods. First one is the RC-NASO method, and second one is the OCPC method, that is O-crasoprolactone complexone method. These two methods are more popular or more routinely used to estimate the serum calcium level. In the clinical significance, there are two conditions. First one is the decrease in serum calcium, that is known as hypocalcemia. and increase in serum calcium, that is known as hypercalcemia. So if there is decrease, this is the normal range, it is known as hypocalcemia, and this is important. You may get a case on hypocalcemia. Symptoms, remember the mnemonic for the symptoms of hypocalcemia, it is CATS. CATS of hypocalcemia. So, convulsions, arrhythmia, tetany, and spasm. Spasm, stridor. So these are the symptoms of hypocalcemia. Convulsion, arrhythmia, tetany, spasm, and stridor. Causes includes decreased calcium. Causes includes rickets, osteomalacia. In menopausal woman, osteoporosis, in which there is decreased bone mineral density. So these are the causes of hypocalcemia. Decrease parathyroid hormone activity and medullary carcinoma of thyroid. In this condition, there is decrease in serum calcium level. If serum calcium level goes below 7 mg per dl, it is a medical emergency and condition is known as tetany. There is typical position of hand, that is known as carpopedal spasm. In the carpopedal spasm, this is a typical condition of hand in which there is flexion of the wrist joint and flexion of the metacarpophalangeal joints, while there is extension of interphalangeal joints. So this position of hand is known as carpopedal spasm. When serum calcium level goes below 7 mg per deciliter, it is known as tetany. It is treated by the injection or injection calcium gluconate. Calcium gluconate 10%, 10 ml over a period of 10 minutes. And then maintenance drip, followed by maintenance drip. So this is the treatment of tetany, carpopedal spasm, and these are the symptoms of hypocalcemia when serum level goes below the 9, that is 8.8, 8.7 something, and when it goes below 7, it is known as tetany. When the serum calcium level increases, it is known as hypercalcemia. More than 11 mg per deciliter. The causes include parathyroid tumor, then secondary metastasis in bone, hyperparathyroidism, metastasis in bone, bone tumor, then multiple myeloma, Paget's disease of bone, etc. In this condition, there is increase in serum calcium level. So these are the conditions in which serum calcium level increases, known as hypercalcemia. There are two important signs in the tetany or hypocalcemia. First one is the Chostek sign. Chostek sign. Tapping of facial nerve causes facial muscle contraction. If you would tap on the facial nerve, it causes contraction of facial muscle. That is known as Chostek sign. And second sign is Trousius sign. if we inflate the BP curve, in a 3 minute there is carpopedal spasm. All about the sources, RDA, biochemical functions, regulation of calcium and clinical significance of calcium. Thank you. Keep watching.